up today.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Hi everyone, Basil Chapman, the host of the Tiger Technician's Hour, 877-927-6648, also the author of The Opening Call. Okay, where are we? That sell signal that went to a sell mode so quickly in the Dow remains in a sell mode, and it'll change only if there is a close above 28,550. I'll have to say there's a possibility that we could go higher, but that's the way it is right now. The Dow is down 141 at 27,889. The peak E that was made in the weekly chart suggests that it'll actually have to be a move even higher than that to 28,700 to suggest that there's going to be now in this particular time period, right at this moment, there'll be a push towards testing the 29,199 high that was made on the 3rd of September. It can happen. I'm just saying it's getting more and more difficult. That's really what I'm saying. If you look at the S&P, although the Dow is holding better because it has the right mix at this particular point, the components, but when you look at the S&P, the 500, that's having a lot more difficulty. And at this stage, we've got 33.49, 37, down 36. Basically, what we're looking at is it's touched the 50-period, this little dashed line here, 50-period exponential moving average for the second time in five sessions. And the MACD is very weak. The stochastic's down at 25%, had been down in the teens, tries to balance. Unbalanced volume is holding quite nicely, but it's still weak. And the relative strength is beginning to weaken. And the relative strength is probably at about 58%. Most importantly, the pattern that we've been talking about for quite some time now is that if there was a sell-off, what we've got to watch is how does it straight line. Remember, in the ChapmanWave, we're looking at three moves. This is what I like to teach. Straight line up, straight line down, that's one. Cup formation, could be a V-shaped formation. Principle is the same, goes from one level, pulls back, goes back to the level. How it treats it, the price point when it gets back there is important. And number three is the arch formation, or the inverted V, going from one point, rallying, coming back, how it treats that left side low. Yeah, you can see the combination of one and three, that straight line down and an arch. If it takes out that left side low, and that's going to make it really important, a close below that and not getting back in there within two sessions says be really careful. So we're on the upside. If you take out the left side high in the reverse, in the green, a reverse Y pattern, that's very bullish. All right, enough of that. What are we looking at? We're looking at, I did not type that in. I thought I had, but I'll do it right now. 3,310.47. 3310.47. That's the low that was made just five sessions ago. Take that out, close below that. And the sharper you close below it, the worse it is. And this just says the best case I can see right now is that this lowercase h pattern can go to a lowercase m as a second small arch unfolds. That's the best case scenario. I'd mentioned that earlier in the week. QQQ, the Index 100 trading vehicle, 268.58, down six. There's that H pattern. I drew it in. We had one little mini H, took out the left side low, had a good rally. That says there should be a chance to go to one of the important moving averages, what I like to teach. And if you can see that it gets repelled at that level, that's a negative. If it goes above that, then look for the left side peak or a doji candle or something. But that left side arch that would be right here on the 10th of September of 282.20, that's taken out, that's very good. If it isn't taken out, instead we're going to the bottom of the ladder, that's going to be very negative. And what is that? 266.90, and that was the low of the 11th of September. here we are at 268.26. Just in, as I'm talking to you, it's increasing. This is not good action. You can see that in the E-mini contract right here. Look at this. This is the Z contract, December. We just look at the way you can follow this line. Look at that pink line. Isn't that beautiful? Just from that moment right there with the price at in the, around about 33.56. We're now at 33.31 and going lower. And that same thing in the two-minute chart. That's the one-minute. Here's a two-minute chart. It's going to leg D to the downside. Okay. So this will be, just to make it clear, I know a lot of people like to look at these. That's a C, and that's a D. This is a D right here. Wow, it's accelerating as we speak. Okay, we're now down 48 in the E-minis. Wow. All right, let's get back to our story. Our story is that the Qs look like they want to test the low that was made on the 11th at 266.90. The IWM holding quite nicely. It's down $1.65 at 153.16. Now, the Dow's holding well. There are a couple of things that I've been talking about, and certainly for my subscribers, they know that we've been looking at low-price stocks, trying to get the upside momentum as money starts to flow out of the tech into other sectors. But you can see that even in the Dow, Caterpillar is holding very nicely here. It is up 4 at 155.58, making a new recovery high. That monthly chart has really improved. This is still leg A. So this tells me that this is a very important rotation. And that in the Dan, let's see, but Dan says, X going the other way, plus 5%. Yeah, so that's true. We are long. We've had, as I say, a number of longs. Yesterday, of course, I was not here for good reasons. You've got the U.S. Steel up 37 at 813. It's up 4.83. We went long at 7.46, and that was 2 days ago. So, yeah, a counter-trend rally, I thought, but with a chance that it could build some momentum if it actually finds enough energy to close above the high that was made of 822, I think 824. 824, the high of the 19th. We had another one yesterday that, for those people who got it, it actually had over 10%. It's a screamer, and did a scream yesterday, and it screamed up over 10% and pulled back, and we're out with a tiny profit, but... in fact, it's still holding very, very well. I just, in this market, I didn't want to take any chances. It's a pity. Probably should have taken a chance, but you never can tell. So, all right, back to our story. And what I did is when in the webinar I did the other night for the Boston Investors Group, Investors Business Daily meetup, Boston meetup group, what it was online, some people around the world were there. I featured the fact that SLX, and I showed this on, it was on Monday night. On Tuesday, I showed this here on my show, that the SLX, the VanEck Vector Steel ETF, was moving very nicely and was breaking out to the upside. That's a really good sign, and it says there is a rotation, that money always finds some pocket of strength, even when there's larger weakness. And I don't know if this is going to last, but that's important. And look at gold. Gold is down 21, but it's still holding steady, and the dollar couldn't hold its rally. I'll be back in a minute. Dow's down 236.
If you're not currently using the TAS profile scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Hi, folks, we're back. And as I said, the Dow's down sharp. The Dow's now down 295. S&P's down 53. What's really important about this, and one of the reasons why we wanted to implement a short this morning, is that on one of the indices, is that those H patterns, a best case scenario, when it looks like this is going to be at least a more concerted sell move or sell mode than normal, is that you would get an H that goes to an M pattern, like this H that goes to an M pattern in gold, down 21. He has the third attempt at a smaller arch formation. But what's really important is that we're in sectors that are quite different. For instance, gold right now, because of the market pullback with the Fed talking lower rates, etc., gold should be finding some kind of support and favor, because this market... Remember on Tuesday night, on Monday night, and then I spoke on Tuesday during my show, and I said, I showed this particular chart, and I said, I mean, what could go wrong, right? It was one of those situations, if I can find it, there it is. I said right here, in number 7, I spoke about dark clouds, and I said in the dark clouds, which potential bad news events could possibly derail this market, any and all? Politics, election, COVID-19, jobs numbers, schools closing, no stimulus package, Fed and rates, earning surprises, etc. But we, even right now, we don't actually have one. What we have is a general market nervousness. I don't think any one of these is in particular the predominant one. And even more importantly, if you look at the politics, I should have put election in here. I meant election politics is the same thing right now. That's lurking out there, because we know that no matter what happens, there will not be a result. November 30th, that night, there will not be a result. In most elections, you have at least something outstanding that's a little bit of a problem, but you get a majority of your information. And then what's left over can be serious or not serious, but it is not the majority. In this particular case, I think there are going to be a lot of repercussions. And I'm looking out, we're talking about September the, 17th today. So this is not yet the election scenario. Is it the political environment? Yep, that's part of it. But I put it in the same category as the election. That is still early in the game. We know that for those of you who've been around for politics and presidential politics. COVID-19, well, we started to get some kind of a scenario. There are a lot better results, but there's a lot of uncertainty, and there's going to be a great deal of skepticism about whatever antidote there is. There's going to be a lot of talk, and I think there'll be quite a lot of people say, hey, I'm not interested if it's got the go-ahead. And actually, I was listening to wasn't a podcast, it was actually a discussion the other day on COVID-19. This is straight from the sources. This is a medical conference. And if you listen to it very carefully, it says there are a lot of things that are going on right now. And there's a great deal of positive. The scenario itself is very positive. Why? Because you've got multi-major institutions, companies, that are really close to something. But we know that it takes a little while to pass, to get everything through the stages. That's number one. Let's just say today everything was passed. To get it out there, it's not like you can just stamp these things and you go click, 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 click. And in 2 days' time, you've got 30 or 40 million. It takes a long time. And then to get it out to the different places. So we're talking time, all right? So that's sitting out there. The jobs numbers, well, still at least 11 to 12 million people. That is a lot without, you know, that we can be pretty sure have not got jobs. So there's a lot. The school closings is going to be a lot of things going on. We've got that here in Massachusetts. Things get shut down, sometimes for silly reasons, but they get shut down. Those silly reasons can turn out to be very serious. I'm saying silly because of silly reasons, not that it can't have an effect. One kid was sent to school by his parents knowing that he had or she had COVID-19 and was sent to school. So that means 30 people or more are now have to have a 14-day quarantine. So these are all, and means that the parents are affected, etc. Stimulus package. I don't think the Democrats want to get any stimulus package. Why would they want that? Well, let's not get into that. Right, enough with that. But you can see what I'm saying, that there isn't one thing right now, and that's saying that when the market comes down, this is the one that I get most scared of. Remember back in October, we had that sell signal. Let me see, where am I putting this? I'll put this over here. Back in October of 2018, it really wasn't until quite a bit later that the real bad news came in. Remember October over there, right there. 26,951 on the Dow, October, and it has a little bit of a fall. Down to 21,712. That's big. Hey, look at this 39% move. So we're getting more and more volatile here. So remember, it wasn't until a little later, especially in December itself, that the real bad news about the Fed raising rates, coinciding with with China. There's a whole bunch of things going on. So when we're looking at this, my fear is that the volatility index right now, look, it's just tiny. It's up. Yep, it's up 7%. It's up 195. But look what it did. Just recently, it went to 38 point. I forgot to put that. Was that 20-something? 38.28 on the 4th of September. And then it plummeted down to the 2484 level. So my fear is that as things get worse and the market keeps pulling back, slowly you'll see a bit of a rise in the VIX index. And then suddenly you get that climactic move and you get a real big smash. And that could actually take many weeks to do. So I'm just saying, I mean, talking about raising cash, or you can have specific stocks that have a particular goal, like the one we just, two that we just had the last couple of days. That's one way to do it. And then you've got to be ready to get out, but it's there. It's almost like a counter trend rate trade. That's all. Okay. Enough with that. Now let's get back to the silver. Silver is down 45 cents at 27.03. Remember, I said stuck in a range. The daily chart is holding a little bit better than the gold daily chart. Weekly chart is still much better. And if you look at the dollar now is down just 10 cents, but it was up at 93.59. Now it's at 93.08. It can't hold the gains. This is a very mixed market. I'll be back in a moment. Basil Chapman, Tiger Commissions Hour, Dow's down 288.
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks, and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman Wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today. If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
So remember, we were looking at this using the ChapmanWave methodology. Look at this one-minute chart. Look, it's still pink. It's just about to flatten out now, getting ready for maybe a little bit of a bounce. And the same thing here in the two-minute, same thing in the five-minute. There's the five-minute here, and then there it is. Now, the other thing that makes me a little bit nervous, I've been noticing that for the last couple of days, is that we've got a little bit of a delay in my platform And trade station is usually very good, even in very heavy days. I've got another platform that's actually usually quite outstanding. It has no delay whatsoever. But I've been noticing that there are a lot of people grabbing positions and filling up the stream. And that says that there's a tiny delay. Some of you might remember back in the old days where we would start to see a 3-minute and a 5-minute delay in the market. Very bad days, you get up to even a 15 or 20 minute delay. Back in 1987, crash of on October the 19th, there was a delay of hours. In fact, in some cases, you couldn't get information until the very next day. So I'm taking this very seriously. There's a question again about a late hour save. Beware acceleration selling into the close or another save rally. I think for now, even though there could be a bounce, I think the saves are kind of done. And I'll just do this real quickly. I'll tell you why. See, as the euro just made a peak F right at the turn of the month, September the 1st, pulls back, peak F, but is holding very nicely. But I wanted to show you something that I think is quite important. Look at the QQQ. Look at the way it gapped down. It's got this thin wick, meaning that there was an open. It closes yesterday around about 276, was it? I'll give you the exact number. It closes at 274.61. It opens today, huge down. It opens today at 267.52. Has a spectacular run of 5 points, 272.37. And now it's down there again. So that's kind of used up the upside strength. That's the way I'm looking at it. Yes, you can get a bounce. But I mean that real upside strength, no, I think this is the H pattern we've got to be careful of. Not only that, for the first time, look at the weekly chart. Remember, I like to always teach these things, always have fun with these. Straight line makes a parallel channel. When you start to break down the channel, when you've been making slightly higher highs and slightly higher lows for months, since the March low, in fact, each peak has been no more than a week. I mean, this is extraordinary. Look at this. Peak A in the weekly chart of the QQQ, 216.51. The next week is 215.88. I mean, 70 cents lower. And then the very next week, new recovery high, continues all the way to peak B. And that's at 247.82. Next week, the high is 247.00. 82 cents lower. And then the very next week, it just keeps doing that until it made the high of 303.33. Now it's 2 weeks, and it's very sharp. You've gone below twice now, 2 weeks in a row. Of course, this is Thursday. Anything can happen between now and Friday. But second week that it's been under the green 9-period moving average. We haven't broken underneath the 14-period moving average in the weekly, which is at 264.43. I needed to just check here. Did I miss something? I don't believe I've had a call. Sometimes when it's quiet like this with no calls, it's telling me that people are looking at the charts very closely because this is a very important moment. And as I say, just ready for a bounce right now. Meantime, back at the ranch, let me just do this. Let me have a quick look at the emails. So the email that was important right here that I wanted to talk about, one came in yesterday. Of course, I couldn't do anything about that. It spoke about the VIX, call buying and the VIX. I think that's very important. But at the same time, we've been looking at some buying in the volatility index as a very good way to hedge, to be able to say, I don't care what happens now because I've locked in what I can lose and what I can make. And if nothing happens between now and even a few weeks' time, I don't mind where I am right now. I think a lot of fund managers are saying, let's try to hold the fort right now. I'm even prepared to give up a 2-3% gain if there is, or even more. I do not want to give back huge gains that we've had. And that's really what I think we're looking at. Questions, let me just see a couple of questions in the dinner I overlooked. as I was doing the work here. We've got. I did that. Could I discuss the weekly volatility index only going to peak C? Now, the person that asked this question should know, since he's done my courses for years, and I know it's something that it's easy to forget, but I'm going to just say it again. Remember that the volatility index is the only, perhaps it's something else, so I better not say it's the only, but it's one of the only indexes that we look at and technical tools that we look at that is a sentiment indicator, and therefore it can fail at any point. Let me just show you the history. Here we go. Look, this is the monthly chart. It went to a peak A and then a B back in 2013. From 1105, it ran up to about 23 or something. Then it came down. Then it made another little A, B, fail. And then, because it took out the low and went to a lower low of 10.28, it only went to an A, B at 31.06 back in 2014, pulls back, and then screams up to a peak C, China plus U.S. interest rates. Again, we're looking back at this. China and domestic, back it goes to 53.29 August of 2015, and then it pulls back and it goes to a lower low. This is the volatility index of 8.84. Remember, one of the reasons why there are one or two numbers that I don't like to talk about too much is that one is my Chapman Wave chin gauge. I don't give those numbers because I've said that at some point they're going to change and it's not fair to give them out, and people think that that's locked in. Nothing's locked in the market, but what is has been fairly locked in, and you can see why I say nothing is absolutely locked in completely and throw away the key, is because the volatility index, you remember I used to talk about the volatility index as being under 11, very bullish. Between 11 and 14, you can get a mixed market, but it's getting less bullish. Once you get into the teens, especially go to the 17, 19 area, you're expecting 100-point Dow pullback, sharp double-digit in the S&P intraday, but maybe it closes off the low. Once you get to the 20s or higher, it's triple-digit down, huge down, and you're done. It's not coming back at the end of the day, and the next day should even open up with a double-digit and triple-digit Dow, double-digit S&P, and close again negatively until it makes a climax. So this is the only index that can fail at an A or a B or a C. And once in a while, like we just saw in the daily, it goes to a D at 38.22 or 24 and it's pulled back. But now we've raised the level because of the whole thing with the COVID-19. The whole level is coming back.
The gold market has taken off topside in a large way in 2020. If you want to take advantage of this sector, now is the time to subscribe to my gold report. The gold report took profits in four of its equities in the gold portfolio in the first week of January for a combined profit of 99.2%, with two positions left in the portfolio that have a profit of 67.5% as of January 7th. The gold report is a comprehensive look at the metal sector as well as the markets that move gold, which is the currency and bond markets. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. Every Monday morning, I publish the Gold Report with coverage of gold, silver, bonds, the XAU, HUI, GDX, as well as more than 30 different mining equities. To see for yourself the types of profitable trades that are recommended within the Gold Report, sign up now by visiting TFNN.com. Don't miss out on the next great gold trade. Sign up today.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
So we've got a huge mover here in ARWR. There's someone in the den who had mentioned it recently. I think it was Buzz Dan. Made a leg D finally in the weekly chart. It was up yesterday. It closed in the 33s to 3 days ago. Tuesday. And then on Wednesday, I had a spectacular move to the 53s. What was the high there? 53.12. And pulled back a little bit today, down 86 cents at 46.53. Wow. Spectacular move. Congratulations. That's right. December the 16th. For ages, you've been talking about this ARWR. Very nice. Okay. So a couple of things. Without getting into the weeds, because sometimes you want to get into the weeds and sometimes you just want to skim over it, like those what are they called? Those things down in Florida, the Everglades, the big propeller, the boat that you sit on, and just like a hovercraft almost. And that's what you want to do. Let me just show you something here. In the big picture, Dow's down 281 right now. In the big picture, no matter how, I couldn't even tell you how many hours I've spent just trying to decipher, to say, in the big picture, is the Dow going to go to all-time highs? I mean, you've got this dark cloud cover sitting out there, any one, let alone three or four or five of these darn things, if they come together in October, this can, talking about ugly, it could get really ugly. But everything about this is suggesting that the Dow is in a buy mode and that it should go to higher highs. Look, the MACD hasn't yet crossed positive. Well, it's the middle of the month. It's still named could deflect low. I think it's going to deflect low briefly, and then afterwards we come back. But the stochastic's running so well, it's up at 75%. But here's the big issue. Is this something that is an aberration, just like the interruption of the mega bull market in February with COVID-19? I don't know what to say. This, no matter how I count, look, the MACD is so strong. Stochastic's beautiful at 85%. On balance volume was overbought. Now it's a little bit less overbought. It's looking good. Here we are in leg A. I can't count it any other way. So that says to me something's going to resolve at some point, and I have an idea what I think it could be. I don't know if it is. I'm just saying I have an idea what it's going to be. But what's really important is that the Fed and the economic statistics, the COVID aspect, every year we get the current word of the word of the year, not the word of the day, and that is mitigate. What was the word that we had once when we were talking about judges way back? Oh, did not have the gravitas. And all of a sudden, because that was the word of the day, it became the word of the week and the word of the month, and then, of course, it disappeared. Who was it? One of the guys up for election, or at least about to be voted in, did not have the gravitas. So that's the word. So the word here is mitigate, and I'll say mitigate, mitigate, mitigate. That's exactly what we want to do. And the only way you're going to be able to mitigate this is that the green 3175 nine-period exponential moving average holds, doesn't even get there, but if it gets there, then you've got the next level in the monthly chart of 3104. That's 2,000 points down from the Dow, in the Dow from here. That's, you know, 200 points down, more than 200 points down from here in the S&P. But that'll do some damage, but it'll probably take a move to get the, it's 120. Yeah, to get the stochastic, actually to get the green monthly nine period moving average below the 14 period moving average, probably down to the 2975 area. Or it's time that every week from now on, it's just lower lows and lower highs. So I'm saying be careful, raise a little cash. You've got core positions, you got them at a low price, you want to keep them. Be prepared that you can lose the percentage gain. But when we get the buy signal, you want to be in this, and it's very hard to get the buy signal and then jump in without losing a bunch of money. I know people that have gotten out of positions in the last since 2008, 2009, a number of times at crises. They couldn't help it because they just got so nervous. They could not afford to lose anything more than was being lost. So they got out, and then when they got back in at higher prices each time. So they're not looking anywhere as good as they should be looking at in terms of positions. So just prepare yourself. Take enough off that you can sleep at night if the worst case happens. But don't take off so much that if it goes back up, you say, oh, no, I'll never be able to get back in again at that level. In some cases, it's just a matter of using your own common sense. You can't have somebody tell you. You've got to say, I'm in here, I'm in there. I'd like to have some money. There's always an opportunity to buy. Hey, opportunity to buy. Look at this. How long have I been talking about this? Amazon makes an all-time high, 35.52. It's trading at 29.78, legs C down. It made the dreaded H in an inverted V and failed. It couldn't get above the left side high. Look at the weekly chart, peak E. Look at Apple. Remember I said that for those of you at the webinar, the Boston Investors Group webinar on Monday night, and then I repeated again Tuesday. I'd said, I don't care what Apple's coming out with. This chart looks like it's going to lower lows and lower highs. And here we are, down almost $3 today at 109.18. It was at 137 at the beginning of the month, and we're only 2 weeks into the month. And the second, it was 137.98. So please, just consider that. I have a big fight about this all the time in my mind. I don't talk to anybody about it, but I just have it in my mind. And that says, sometimes, for instance, we're still long from March the 23rd, the Dow. We've got a call option. We've got the diamond. And I'm saying I'm prepared to give up some of the gains, knowing that there's going to be a decline. But I don't know how to, the next get. Entry point is going to be really tough, I think. But I could be giving up a lot. So I'm going to mitigate that by doing something for subscribers over the next day or so. And that way I can feel comfortable, everybody can feel comfortable, say, yeah, go down. I'm expecting you to pull back quite a bit more. But I want to add to this position, if I'm correct. But at the same time, there's this thing that says, there's greed and fear. And people say, oh, don't get too greedy. Well, you know, if you're in a position that you really like, for instance, we're in Agilent. And we've taken quite a bit off all the way up. We still have a core position. We're in from 70. It hit 102.66. But I'm looking at the chart, and the chart says, this is in the wheelhouse of the market right now. It's holding so well. It even had a fabulous run from 94 to 100. that 6 points just in a couple of days. It's reluctant to give up. What do you do? I'm not trying to be greedy. I'm just saying I like the position. I would like to hold the position. And I do understand that it could pull back. There's a big difference between greedy and trying to make...
Back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006. And like many of you, was drawn in by... Bam! As well as...
Whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us. And Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab. Bam!
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks. This is Steve Rhodes. Stay tuned for another great hour of the Trader's Edge heard here at TFNN.com.
So the answer is, rotating those calls to the question I just got. Paul says, X also makes no money, but A, which is Agilent, is a real company that makes dollars but is overvalued. I can't disagree with any of that. So there you are. So here we go. We're just about to wrap up. You're going to be going to, I think Steve Rhodes recorded this morning. Is that right? And then we'll go to, we've got Dave White. And then, of course, you've got Tom O'Brien. So the Dow is down 238. You can see by this pattern in the weekly that we're really just going sideways. To really tank the market, you have to see the Dow start to close under 27,000. That's the Dow. For the S&P, very well-deserved retracement on going on right now to really start to see further decline, erosion under 32.71, 32.81 is the 14-period moving average, and it's at 33.38. That's quite a way to go. And that's the way I want to do it, just step by step. QQQ made a lower low, but now we'll see. Is it going to went to 26.68? Trying to rebound to get back into the arch formation. That means you've got 2 days here that are very important. Hey, have a wonderful session. Have a rest of the day. A good day. I'll see you tomorrow. Check out my opening call, my daily newsletter. And thank you for being here. Have I just beaten the bell? I think so. Could I do that? Yes, I certainly will. All right, I'll be back in another few minutes just to do the wrap-up, the 1 o'clock update, and we're going to listen for the music. Music, music, music. Oh, let's just do this as we're waiting here. There it is. So here we are. I said there could be a bit of a rally in the next set. Was about 10 minutes ago. Here we are. We're getting this rebound. Now the S&P is only down 47, the E-mini. The very important resistances of the 200-period moving average, 3336, so 3337. That's what you got to watch. If there's a close in the next hour and a half above 3337, we could have just a sideways drift into the close. If this fails and you go back and you start to test 3320 again, or 3318, sorry, 3318, take that out, that's a real problem. Okay, folks, I'll be back in a few minutes just for the update. Have a great day. See you tomorrow.